but one of the many bars that are overseen by some of the people working under Romeo. Probably not the good bar where all the pilots gather, though. All those pilots that Romeo trains. They have their own pilot bar close to the hangar.
Yeah.
So the shitty bar?
Yeah, you go to the shitty bar. The one where a lot of Hodor's people end up at.
As soon as Wolfgang gets there and finds a table, she immediately deploys her antibacterial defenses, and that's just like a sloosh of antibacterial, like, spray all over the table. Because I totally made my phobia germophobia.
Yep, and true to Hodor's people, who is slowly integrated with the crew every time you guys take crew losses, this is where numerous beastmen and boil-covered, pockmarked mutants, creatures with giant pulsating muscle arms, enormous eyes and boils.
Any of those get close to getting sprayed.
And some of the less judgmental or less well-off crew here.
We need to think of a name for this bar right now.
The Weeping Syphilis.
Alright, let's not name this bar right now, then.
It's obviously the Under-Overdeck.
Because you knew there were no
The Under-Overdeck! Yes! I like that, actually.
Under-Overdeck it is, I guess.
That's good.
Okay, so you guys meet at your usual table at in the Under-Overdeck.
I just want to point out how much Peeps, my dude, sticks out because his quirk is stunningly attractive and this place is full of mutants.
This table is just lathered in antibacterial stuff.
So, yes, the remainder of you come upon a slightly damp and gel-covered table. And roll awareness, anyone who has it. That is not as assumed in Dark Heresy as it is in Rogue Trader. They don't just hand that shit out like candy. I mean, I guess anyone can roll awareness.
I got it.
Is that on your Romeo sheet or your Titus sheet?
That is on Titus.
Okay, it's using our screen name. Right, okay, gotcha.
Yeah. I'll switch it real quick, because why not?
I don't have it trained, but can I still roll?
Yeah, you can roll it untrained.
Cool, 19.
Knock yourself out.
I did.
And let's go ahead and use Dark Heresy. Let's go ahead and use Dark Heresy. I think it's only minus 20, not half. Run turn.
Okay.
Same as weapon. I mean, you still failed the fuck out of that.
Yeah.
Yeah, go ahead and toss out a minus 20 perception check for Bob. Minus 20 Bob check.
What kind of check, sorry?
Perception.
Sorry?
Well, awareness. So
okay.
That ain't good. Okay.
I didn't see nothing.
Yeah, so most of you don't hear any of this. Ferris catches some bits and pieces as you guys come in. Titus, very appropriately, is the one who actually hears the comments being spouted.
That pretty boy should be up with the Lord Gaius. Exchange hair tips and makeup and whatever they do.
Titus does nothing.
It's called manscaping, thank you very much.
Yeah, this is Titus's problem, not mine. I don't care.
I've got just as much hair as them, it's just not in all the same places.
Gripping a thing of antibacterial soap a little harder.
But eventually, eyes stop lingering on you as you take a seat and are there for a little bit. This is ultimately a place for weird people, and even though you're weird among the weird people for not being weird, that makes you weird, so eventually you become normal.
Hooray!
Scene is just another mutant. A mutant whose mutation is being really pretty.
Also having an eye on his right hand, but no one needs to know that.
Are you a parasite?
No, it's warp mutations. He's got a bunch of corruption points.
That's right, he does.
You wish you did have Parasite. Or a Parasite.
But you have all come here to discuss the matter of Agent Tenebris's orders that have been handed down. That he wishes you, the Tenebris Cell, to do everything in your power to ensure that that diplomatic relations with the Loyalist Tau are never possible, or are rather ruined, and that diplomatic relations with the Renegade Tau will never be possible.
Well, one sounds harder than the other.
That it does indeed, but both are our duty.
Well then, where should we start first?
And let's, for the sake of argument, say that you guys are aware of the occurrences up to this point.
Well, our contact has informed us that we've captured an imperial agent. Or a renegade Imperial Arbides. Seems like getting rid of her would go a long way towards ruining relations with the renegades on the ground.
Rather than getting rid of her, why didn't you just send her back to where she came from, you know?
Break her in the hands of,
prison break. That's an idea.
Well, we don't know if...
We could poise a separatist, lead her to a jailbreak, and then spread those rumors around the ship to help sow dissent.
What spread rumors that a town did it or something?
Spread rumors that rebels somehow got him onto the ship.
All right. Okay.
Well, we have.
Or maybe it was the loyalists, and then just saw even more doubt.
It would have to be the town at this point. How else would separatists get up here?
Ooh, I like the loyalists. That sounds like an even better plan.
We blame the loyalists. Yes.
We frame loyalists.
Yes, yes, yes.
There should be at least one on our ship, or more. I believe there was one specific one. I can't remember who what their name was.
Oh, Bell. He's the head of the water cast. Miser is business. It wouldn't be too much of a stretch to make it think like he's been being, make them think that he's been a double agent all along.
Yep, that'd be good.
And it cuts them off to information they have on the ground.
So how are we going to plan this jailbreak? What are the steps going to be?
Well, do we know if they're being held? I'm asking that out of character. Do we actually know where they are?
Bob and Krell, roll intelligence.
Yeah. Do we have fate in this game? I'm pretty sure we do.
Yes, you do have fate.
I have a common lore underworld, if that helps.
No, you got it. I'll roll anyway, but... No.
And you're not sure what your fate is, Josh?
Yeah, I don't know.
You were Death World, right?
Yeah, I'm pretty sure it was two.
I can get it for you here in a second.
It was either two or three. I think it's actually three, because I think I said that's not more than Thaddeus did.
Does fate work in the exact same way as it does in Rogue Trader?
Basically.
Okay, cool.
I mean, certainly fate rerolls do. Okay, cool. And for a death world, you start with two fate, but if you roll a 1d10 and get 5 or higher, you have 3 fate.
I think I got 3.
Okay, go ahead and put 3 on your sheet. The fate section is down at the bottom.
Oh, yeah, there it is.
I checked your sheet and saw it wasn't there, but yeah. How much fate do you know have?
Do you know what the wounds are? I don't have that wrote down either. Like, how much do you get from being a death world or whatever?
1d5 plus 9.
Plus 9?
Yeah, no.
I'll roll it now, because I don't know what it is.
Yeah, it's fine.
See, plus 9.
Yeah, plus 9.
Yeah.
Forge World Wounds?
Yeah.
Moment. Forge World Wounds, 1d5 plus 8. You guys actually have pretty decent wounds compared to your Rogue Trader characters.
Yeah,
so,
I have 9 on Thaddeus.
So, Bob Scruffy Johnson.
Yep.
You know where that little lady's being held. She was, You know exactly which section of the brig she's in. We were guarding that area just the other day.
Well, I think I might be able to help out with this situation then. I know precisely where this one is and how we can bust him out.
How many guards are usually patrol the cells? I'd assume more than one.
It There's usually a decent contingent of at least 5 of them. This is a higher priority prisoner, however. In which case, I would turn the question back around on you guys. Would your characters have suggested higher levels of security?
I don't know. Maybe the captain would, but I'm not sure specifically.
I can tell you that I was already thinking of it with Romeo. So, yeah. I mean, she would at least have the ex-guardsmen. The same number, because they're the best we have. The ones off the sets.
Right, the...
Especially because, like, right before we captured her, we saw her bend a power maul with the force of her, like, with her grip. That's pretty fucking scary. And she's a woman with a cause, which is also pretty scary.
Yeah.
And there's also some fire warriors there. Well, 2, 3 of them? I'm pretty sure Hodor cut 1 in half.
I want to say 3. Because one of them would be out of the suit, right?
Oh, yes. 2 of them were basically just more or less untouched, but surrendered. The captain fucked 1 up. Like, he done got fucked. He's fucked up. It's possible, depending on your guys' preferences, that he's actually in the, Persian's bed.
The what?
Possibly being tended to by your doctors, if you guys intend to tend to the Fire Warrior with your doctors after you beat the crap out of him.
Romeo was against it. Not because, mostly because we don't want to piss off the Tau that we're allied with right now. Like, he would go to the point that if there were bodies, he would try to take the bodies back as well, just so they can get proper burials or whatever the hell the Tau do with their dead. He doesn't really know.
Oh, right. So medical assistance to the extremely injured Tau, or no?
We're still trying to go the negotiation route, probably.
I mean, Romeo would suggest it, and in terms of just pure optics, it's a good thing to do that doesn't cost as much, so.
Okay, I don't think you guys actually harmed any of the humans. Well, I mean, you completely fucking killed 1 or 2 of them, I think. I'm not sure.
Yeah, well, Thaddeus killed 1, and I killed 1.
But I don't think any of the ones who were alive were injured, just horribly traumatized and temporarily blinded.
Yeah, sounds about right.
Physically,
3 surrendered, 1, 2 died. First time?
Was that?
Nothing.
Okay. Oh, wait, 4 Tau, because you pulled 1 out of a stealth suit.
Yeah.
Oh, we have a stealth suit, yeah.
Yeah, you have a stealth suit with a fusion gun, and, you have 2 renegade Arbites in the prison. You have Catherine, and 3 Tau, and 1 Tau in the medical bay.
And the body of 1 water cast Tau.
Yes. Probably also in the medical bay. But so yes, there is actually higher than average security in the brig at the moment. Your brig is not particularly expansive aboard the Zenith. Having a fancy, expensive brig is actually a ship component that you don't have. But obviously you have a brig.
Yeah, I can say that Romeo is definitely most worried about the Arvidi's captain, because the Tau seems super scary, but they also seem like too goody two-shoes to really pull some crazy shit. That lady, though, she's got looser morals, so she's going to be willing to do some crazy shit.
So yeah, you'd say there's probably 5 guys patrolling the cell area, 5 guys on standby to run in, and 5 more patrolling the perimeter around the brig. heightened security. And they're all Sodal guardsmen.
So what we need is a distraction.
Sodal 39th guardsman, Geralt's old unit. And, well, if distraction is what you guys think you want to go with, there's 15 dudes there.
The question is, how do we get around that, and then how do we make it seem like it was the tail?
Do any of you have logic trained?
Yes.
Roll logic, especially because you asked the question. You do have the recovered Tau weapons in the ship's armory.
So that's a start.
Oh. We should, this would kind of suck for the other group. We should send her away with the stealth suit.
None of us can actually offer
it. It wouldn't be able to fit it.
None of us can fit it, none of us can pilot it, none of us can move it.
Or we should sabotage it.
But that just seems to be getting out of the way for something, so, not really our mission.
Yeah, it wouldn't really help anything. That would just make it worse. For us, better for them.
We should arm the prisoners. Whether they get killed or get off ship doesn't really help us either, or it doesn't really matter to us either way. So we might as well have them do the heavy lifting for us.
Yeah, okay, so what are we going to do? I can maybe do an influence roll to see if I can actually get the weapons out of the armory.
Why don't you steal them?
I think we should try influence first.
Well, it's a resource that, it goes away. So you're spending it. It's not like a normal roll.
Only when you use it to get a huge shit, like those ally weapons. Right.
Yeah, I could, or I can use my influence to make it easier for us to steal. Like, I could, roll influence to see if I could, bribe the guards off their posts for a certain period,
That's cool. Mine's also fairly high, it's 39.
You're an accountant. Just make up a date and give them the guns.
Make up a what?
Just make up an armsman. Just make up an armsman unit, and then give them the guns.
Yeah, but then I guess that can be traced back to me. If I bribe them subtly,
that can still get traced back.
It can get traced back to me, but they're not gonna.
So if you're good at obscure paper, it's not gonna get back to you either.
True.
Here's a question: have a security camera in the area? That can also do it.
Well, there are certainly security camera type devices all over the place.
So those would have to be hacked somewhat.
Alright, let me use influence to draft up a fake warrant then for the guns, for an Imperial Guard unit, and then our two Imperial Guardsmen can go down and acquire them.
Well, notably with influence. Influence is specifically your stat that is your influence with the Inquisition. So you can definitely use influence, but that's you basic. I mean, you may be a little subtler about it than this, but that's basically you going up and saying, hey, I'm with the Inquisition. Do what I say.
Okay.
If you're using it to try and persuade people to do things.
Okay, so what if I write, like... We could use middlemen, I guess. I don't know.
I mean, like, obviously, yes, you can try to create forged documents.
Would that be deceive?
That would be deceive. Or commerce.
I have deceive trained. So let's just see how well I can forge a document. Well, it is passable.
That's a passable forged document. So it depends on who you're showing it to.
It's just going to be shown to the people that are guarding the armory at the time, I guess. And take the weapons. Are we just going to send somebody, some random? Guys?
I mean, I'm a janitor, so I don't know what you want me to do.
I mean, I don't mind picking them up. That's not a problem.
Or we, all right. we get random people to pick it up, and then somebody like stealthily ambushes them. That way, they think that the Tau knocked them out, and that way there isn't obvious it was with these people and they did it.
Sure, that's fine.
All right, yeah, I'll send them. I'll send them to get the weapons and tell them to deliver it to a certain spot, and that's when we ambush them, because we can set up ambush at that spot, or on their en route to that spot. And you can turn off the cameras in that area. Okay, that's what the document says. I'm just going to give it to a guardsman and say this requisition needs to be fulfilled. Just grab it out of the armory and deliver it to a guardsman at this location.
Probably just a lowly scribe.
Yeah.
Given where you are.
Yeah, just describe them.
The equivalent of an intern.
Okay.
But okay. That's not a bad plan. So yeah, in that case, the scribe shuffles off.
All right, and when he's doing this, I'm literally just beelining the other way. I'm getting changed into my gear.
Also, it has to be gun, because Tau.
It could be a las weapon. I mean...
I'm just saying, sucky melee would not automatically think Tau.
Okay, yeah, I'll use my last sniper. I don't take penalty for called shots, because I took precision killer.
Just don't hit the ship.
No. Alright. Anybody else want to come? For this ambush or not?
I assume we'd all go.
Alright.
Oh yeah, I'm going.
Tech to hack something.
Yeah, either tech use or security to bring down the monitoring equipment in the area. I assume your tech use is better.
Yep.
Also, here's another thing to do with this plan. Capture one of the guardsmen, keep him blindfolded, and I'll try to feed him telepathic suggestions that he's been captured by Tau.
But it's... The only person that we're going to be ambushing is this fucking scribe that's delivering the weapons. Like, it's
so
just one guy.
So I guess we're capturing this scribe.
Okay.
and doing some not nice things to him and making him think that it's all been the town.
I'm going to call and shot him in the leg when he shows up.
Yeah, I guess I should do that to Keith first.
If you didn't blow it off.
Everybody a minute, okay?
What was that? Oh, that's what that was.
Nope.
Holy crap.
Same roll. Nice.
Good game. Same exact roll.
Wait. Can you use a fate point to auto-succeed on tech stuff?
He's a seer.
Yeah, I'm a sage. I can use
for sage,
to succeed
yeah.
at logic or a personal task.
Okay. Fair enough.
But so at the very least, you know you haven't brought the cameras down. You're not unaware of that fact.
Yeah, so I guess the change to the plan
we're just gonna,
would be
we're just
to
gonna
have him fuck,
shoot it.
Mindfuck him to go someplace that doesn't have cameras that we know of.
Or we shoot out the cameras.
Then
we know
the camera
where the...
will see you shooting out the camera.
No, not if we do it from an angle that is not being like filmed at that
also,
time.
Don't
have you never played stealth
machine.
Games? Have you ever played?
So I guess make a stealth check and then shoot the camera.
Yeah, I guess that's what we're gonna have to do.
Can't you mindfuck him to go someplace that doesn't have cameras?
I could definitely try. I can't implant. I can make small lies seem incredibly true. It's like,
Delude?
Mind tricking. Yeah, Jedi mind tricking.
Yeah, I had that power too. It was awesome. I never actually got to use it,
but
it's awesome.
I have master paths that can do that for Denov.
So yeah, I feel like if we keep this guy barely in a state of consciousness, and then I can throw in a few of those in. Him being captured by Tau or thinking he heard Tau language isn't that far of a stretch. But I don't know if leaving him somewhere else is.
Alright, I'm going to try to shoot out the cameras then.
Like, I'll, like, give him... make him think that he hears somebody telling him to go over towards a certain area.
Also, does anyone have does anyone have security?
I do.
Okay, because you can also attempt a security roll.
Okay.
Alright. Does that succeed with fate?
You have to add it up beforehand.
Fine, I'm going to re-roll it then.
Well, let Welperga attempt security.
I'll lie.
He's taking the good rolls.
I just failed one.
Here, now you're taking the goal.
Alright, never mind.
Oh.
Never mind my roll.
Does it.
Alright, I'm going to get up on the... whatever the equivalent of rafters are, and just set up my gun down the hall, the way I know he's going to be coming, and readied... Actually, I can't spend a turn using the accurate stuff if I ready a shot, can I? No.
No, you have to have an aim beforehand, and then call the next turn. But I mean, assume if he's walking, you would have the surprise anyway to aim. Like, he's not going to see you while you're aiming.
Okay, yeah, sure. Perfect.
Okay, so Walpurg gets in there. She wasn't able to do it with your typical... actual engineering the machine spirit of that thing, but she was able to get in there and disable it like a proper thief would. She knows the weakness of the machine and can subvert it.
We don't call it weakness. I feel like that would be on Messiah heresy.
How come your Dark Heresy game ended, Eric? Everyone
you know,
died, probably.
Klaus in the Trader game. You know how he can't attend the sessions?
No. I mean, I know he can't, but I don't know why.
School. He was the GM.
Oh, okay.
Threvin's actually been really good so far.
Yeah.
Has he GM'd before?
I have no idea. He wanted to do a game of Engine Heart previously, but while conceptually interesting, it wasn't quite my thing. Which is basically a game where you play sentient machines after the world has ended, but you're just like sentient machines that were common household machines, like you're a sentient toaster or something.
What? That just sounds really weird and kind of dumb.
Like trying to find your way in the post-apocalyptic world with the other sentient machines, like sentient dishwashers and whatnot.
I'd choose a dodo. Sentient dodo.
Yes. Hilarious.
Conceptually interesting, but only because I played Primordia, and I loved Primordia. And I am copy-pasting some things here, so that's why I'm not immediately moving forward. Okay, so yes, after quite a bit of ministrations upon the machines, Walpurga is unfortunately unable to coax them into cooperating and is forced to apply a little bit more discipline. Like a dog that won't quite behave, she has to get a little bit more serious with it. But the area is unmonitored. Beyond the fact it's unmonitored, it is a fact in and of itself. Or would be, eventually. No one knows for now. You're at about the halfway point between the armory and the captain's laboratory. You know that the captain had already put in some orders to have the Tau weaponry brought down to the Xenos Technology study area. So it was a relatively simple matter to arrange for it to be brought a little bit earlier than expected. And I don't have time for a full map setup, but kind of have time for a little bit, which I am setting up.
I'm going to keep that stealth roll.
Yeah, no, I mean, anybody who wants to stealth is more than able to stealth because it is situationally appropriate.
Do I have to make a stealth roll if I just don't move behind the wall?
If you are completely and totally out of sight, you don't need to make one, but the moment you start doing anything, you're going to be noticed.
Okay, that's what I'm going to do.
You essentially get no stealth bonuses. You just, you know, in terms of the flow of the situation, will not be immediately noticed.
Okay, that's what I'm going to do, because my agility is garbage, and I'm not trying to stealth. So, yeah.
Okay, and... Wait, what screen am I on right now? This one. Yes, there we go.
You literally got the Scruffy token.
I did. I got the Scruffy token. That was the first thing I did. Nice. Like, as soon as that was mentioned, I had a Scruffy token made.
Hey.
Love it. What token is our unsuspecting victim?
This guy flanked by two armsmen who were escorting the arms shipment.
That's where I am.
Yeah, I feel like I should be hidden around here because I only have a hand cannon. I was mostly just here to turn off stuff.
Well, this is a situation where the guys that you guys used to throw in front of yourselves when you failed dodge checks are actually the roughly equivalent power level enemies in this situation to you guys.
Oh boy.
Where would the like panel better one or like this where I would have done security from?
Where you were taking care of the security?
Yeah.
Let's say I'm going to draw a blue circle.
Okay, and about how long before they got here would I have been able to actually finish that?
Given your failed rolls and need to reassess, enough to make it to one alcove away.
Okay, so like back here-ish. It's basically staying in Vermeer's way. Good luck. Thumbs up with the mechadendrites. With the Swiss Army mechadendrite.
Now I picture the Amy Pond thumbs up thing, but with like a bunch of arms.
I feel like the Swiss Army mechadendrite is the only one that that actually works for fingers. Other than that, I have the optical one and I have the Medicaid one. So if you guys get fucked up, I can heal you.
Yeah, don't worry about it. I'm running like a non-combat character too, so yeah.
I'm just standing here like on guard with Bob.
I'm stealthed in is there a rampart? Are there like ramparts or like not ramparts, but like vents or like are there like I don't know.
Is there like shit on the ceiling that you can be attached to or inside of?
Yes. I have a grapple hook and stuff.
Yes. There are, basically it's big vaulted ceilings heading towards the research bay. It's an important area of the ship. And it has those enormous cavernous imperial ceilings to it.
Okay.
What was your stealth roll? I know it was decent.
2.5 degrees of success. Okay, 50. Yeah. My stealth is 50. So, 75. No, never mind. 35? There must have been 35.
Okay, so, yeah.
We're basically waiting for Mike to give us the signal, I guess? Or
I'm just going to fire, and that'll be the signal.
The signal is a motherfucker dies.
Yeah. I think I'm not going to actually shoot the main guy first. Actually, should I decripple him and get the... Who's carrying the gear? Does he just have Are they all carrying it? Is it like just a
this,
big
that's what the
or...
red thing is. It's assume it's like yeah. a big box of goo.
Yeah, the red thing is the cart that he is pushing that has the Tau equipment locked inside of it.
Alright, we can't let him escape.
Gotta leave you guys... one alive to think that it's the Tau.
I'm gonna wait till they get to here.
I can probably not kill one since I have a melee weapon.
And then I'm gonna fire on one of the guardsmen with a full aim. What is the bonus on a full aim?
On an accurate weapon, it's 30.
30?
Yeah, you get 20, but then you get plus 10 because it's accurate.
20, 30, and then so
sure that works.
It's gonna be 40 because of my fucking red dot sight. So we'll.
And unaware, so another 30, so you cap out at 60.
Should I fate that and get a full... try to get 4 degrees of success? To get the extra d10? No, okay, fine. So roll 1d10 plus 4... And then an additional roll, 1d10. And it is tearing.
What's it say, so, Pete?
Pen 4.
Okay, so
it has it has felling 4 as well.
I think felling just ignores... is that proven? No, I think felling just ignores unnatural toughness.
Yeah.
Oh, I thought it ignores regular toughness.
No, it is unnatural.
Okay. That's actually... those rolls are shit. We're shit! Can I roll... Is tearing mean I can re-roll the accurate d10 as well?
That's pretty good, though. I mean, that almost kills a person. But yeah, I'm pretty sure you can roll the original d10.
But the extra damage from the accurate is what he's asking about.
If I do, if I can re-roll that, I get a 9.
But no, it's just you roll one extra die and discard the lowest result, so you only re-roll one.
Oh.
Okay. All right.
So in that case, I mean, I guess that 9 is in place of the 4 on your original roll?
Yeah.
Okay, and that is a... That's a 13, body shot.
14, 18 in the body. Oh, I can call it. I can call it at no penalty.
Oh, you can?
It's going to be a headshot.
Oh, right. That is a headshot. Lovely. Okay.
Why do you want to headshot him? I thought, we want to kill one of them at least.
Okay, so that man's head is incinerated, and his flaming body goes running off in this direction.
Shit, we're going to have to put out the fire. I hope it doesn't start.
Wait, he goes running off? That's hilarious.
Yeah, that is the highest level energy thing. Their headless corpse goes running off for 2d10 meters in a random direction. Anything flammable it passes, including characters, must make an agility test or catch fire.
Awesome.
Oh, but also his head did explode, and brain and skull matter was sent spraying out in flaming hulks, flaming hunks across everybody. Well, everybody there. None of you were actually hit with flaming brain pieces. Well, actually, I suppose Bob and Krell roll agility to see if you were hit with pieces of flaming brain and skull.
It's not me this time.
Or I guess dodge, which is still an agility check, but... Yeah, Bob, let's see if you were hit with flaming pieces of a guy's head.
Actually, that makes no sense for it to explode that way, though. If I'm shooting it, like, physics would dictate it explodes backwards.
Except in the case of an energy weapon, it's not exploding from force of impact, it's exploding from overheating and then combustion.
Yeah, I was about to say, he'd probably actually just boil the blood in his head and then cause, like, a rapid steam build-up thing. Kind of like a piece of popcorn.
Yeah, an explosion from an explosion from an energy weapon would be centered upon the center of the point of impact, like a grenade that you shot.
Yeah, you're not Cyclops. You don't shoot like beams of force.
Yeah, Bob, roll. Assuming we have Bob still. If Bob, Scruffy Bob.
Bob died.
Bob is here. What can Bob do?
Bob is here. Oh my god.
Dodge.
Oh my god. Oh my god.
Bob's here. He was all just right. he was
Bob
napping
Bob
a little bit.
Bob
dodged
that.
Bob Dole doesn't have to take any of this crap.
What did we learn? Don't call shot head.
Why not?
Yeah.
Great.
Well, not if you don't want to make a mess.
Why wouldn't you want to make a mess in this situation? You want to send a message.
We just don't want, like, this entire ship, half of the part of the ship catching on fire.
Takes a lot more to catch part of the ship on fire. Takes starship-grade weaponry to do that.
Yeah, I'd say one dude.
Considering everything's made of metal, it doesn't really matter. It's not like it's going to spread.
Well, the fire will spread if it's something like electrical systems catching fire and, you know,
yeah,
apartment block-sized plasma cannons ripping into your ship's hull. But not one dude firing a sniper rifle into another guy's head and then flaming bits of brain matter. But, by the way, Bob, dodge.
Dodge roll.
That's failed for me because it's actually a dodge roll.
Well, technically, it's an agility test. Technically. It always has...
Yeah, but I'm not trained in dodge. But if it's just an agility test, I succeed.
It doesn't technically call for an agility test on this, but it always does on critical.
I think Bob's gonna retry that one.
Burp.
Okay, well, Bob's slightly happier with that result.
Jeez.
Okay, so,
feel like our very first mission.
Okay, so Bob is unfortunately splattered with some flaming bits of brain and face tissue and skull from the unfortunate guardsman whose headless flaming body went running off into an alcove.
Wouldn't be the first time. Hopefully ain't the last.
Hopefully.
He reminds me of my dinners on the Feral World.
Anyone who wants to roll initiative, go ahead and do that.
Just looking to see if I have anything that gives me a bonus to initiative.
And that's a 1d10 plus your agility bonus, so the 10's place of your agility. Bob?
Sorry. I forgot to add my agility, so mine's 8, not 5.
So, this level in our other campaign, I can get lightning reflexes at 7 out of 7 modifier. It's ridiculous.
So good, man.
So I'm rolling 1d10 plus...
your agility bonus.
Also, I just want to put this out there to Mike. You were never at the level. You actually start like the equivalent of like Dark Heresy level 5 or 6. Which is why, you know, we suck. Is because like we're not even close to Rogue Trader power yet.
I know that. I'm just saying.
Okay, but yeah, so let's see. What's your agility on Bob? 44. 1D, okay. Alright, so technically by the initiative order, Ferris does get another shot.
I take a half shot to half action to aim.
Okay, half aim.
And then what are the total? What's the total? I'm gonna shoot the other guardsman. What is the total bonus I would get on that? So
right now that's they know you're there now, so that's only plus 10.
Well, 20 is accurate.
Oh, yeah.
And 30 because of the red dot sight. Okay. Oh, wait. What's the charge pack? Is it? Is the charge pack... with the charge pack, that means I have to reload now, right?
If that's what you're using.
Yeah. And, but I have rapid reload, so what does that give me? Is that, like, a reload in half the time?
Yeah, probably. Let me have a look.
The reload speed on your gun normally?
Two full?
Okay.
Probably so one full then.
Yeah, so it would just be a full turn to reload your gun. Do you have another gun?
I have a last pistol.
Up to you if you want to try and use that. Or reload your gun.
I'm gonna reload.
Okay.
Yeah, it's Hall's reloading times.
Okay, so Krell, you're run across from these guys.
I'm gonna charge. For one, what is this? What is this abomination?
That is technically a Shadowrun street ganger. if you can taste the 80s and 90s on him. But more specifically, that is the scribe who is pushing the cart.
Okay, should we keep him alive then? If that's the case, I'll just fucking run at the other guy. What's the charge? I just say charge, doesn't it? 9, so I can run at 9.
Yeah, and charge is plus 10 weapon skill.
Okay, so this guy's getting fucked up. Do I modify a plus 10?
Although they have all seen you at this point.
I fell. I'll reroll it. I need just.
But it is just.
Oh yeah, I got a lot of damage. Total damage, but it's a pen. I don't know.
Pen zero.
Pretty zero, actually, yeah.
Yeah.
It's also shocking.
Shocking is relevant. You might say, shockingly.
No, I wouldn't say that. I would never say that.
That would be the last thing I would have ever said. Have to.
Well, you said you might say.
Well, I am saying it now. Those words are coming out of me. That just happened.
I don't know what it is. It's like some sort of toughness test?
Oh, for the shocking?
Yes.
Yes, although I believe it is proportional to the damage they took and the armor they have on the area you hit.
Are you sure? They have to take at least 1 point of damage.
Which they did. That happened.
Must take a toughness test that he receives a plus 10 bonus for every armor point he has on that location. If he fails, he's stunned to another round equals to the half damage he took.
Let's see. Once again, the Dark Heresy 2 rules are better because they have been playtested more. They removed the bonus for armor to that location.
Good. Good. I'm just going to look at the Dark Heresy books now. I'm just never looking at the Rogue Trader ones.
I mean, it can be relevant to check the Rogue Trader book, but the Dark Heresy and Black Crusade are the most up-to-date rules, so if there's a rule that's the same thing in both books, it's usually a better, more playtested version of it in Dark Heresy 2 and Black Crusade.
Yeah. That seems to be the case. I'm not sure whether I should take the psychic powers from Dark Heresy or Rogue Trader.
Okay, let's see. Toughness test. Oh, he passes. He's not stunned, but he's smacked.
Is that my full turn? I believe it is, but I don't know.
Yes, that was your charge. That is your full turn.
Yeah.
But you did smack this guy good. Where did you hit that guy? What was that attack roll? That was a 95. Yeah. Well, a 59-95. Yeah, so you smacked him right in the leg. That guy screamed out, dropped down to a knee. You heard something crack. He could probably still walk on it, but something cracked.
Ouch.
Well, Perga.
Well, for now, in case anyone needs help, but figure they have this handled.
It does seem decently handled. Bob Johnson.
Oh, wait.
There is a fairly heavily injured guardsman, and a terrified scribe who does not know why he is covered in bits of flaming brain. Is there anyone you planned a desperado today?
Is that me?
That's you.
Okay.
That is your turn. One guy who just got his leg cracked with a big, sparky stun stick. And one scared accountant who wonders what the hell is going on and why he's covered in flaming brains.
I'll go for the crippled one.
Oh, right. And not... It is your preference, but as a desperado, you can also take a move action and then fire as a free action. Although I don't know if you have to move here.
Oh, I forgot. I get additional damage equal to the degrees of success on my hitting stuff.
Okay, so you exploded his head even more.
Yeah.
So his head is like 3 times more exploded or whatever.
Nice.
So, yeah, I don't think it matters at this range.
Yeah, in which case, you can actually take a aim action to add plus 10 to your attack roll, if you're not planning on moving.
I would like to do that. And what that is my souped-up gun, that is a standard weapon? Or is it a ballistic?
Ballistic. Weapon skill is melee, ballistic skill is guns.
Gotcha.
What's the range on your gun, by the way?
A good question.
Hotshot las pistol. It's in your sheet.
You're probably getting an extra plus 10 for being within half range.
My range is 20, so I think I'm within 10.
Yep, I assume, you are.
I assume this whole thing in Dark Heresy. I'm not sure, but...
I'm assuming, but yeah, you're only 7 meters away.
Okay, so in that case, it would be plus 20 to my roll, or minus 20, but yeah.
If you...
What did I roll?
56.
I don't know what I did wrong. Yeah, I'm good.
Oh, yeah, that's registering as a minus 20 for some reason. I mean, you still wouldn't have passed that, but...
I have a suggestion that means he could have passed it.
If he could so have I think aimed, that's 1.8 degrees of success? Or is it 0.8? It's 0.8 degrees of success.
So it would have been 36 without the minus 20.
Well, he rolled a 56, and it was 44 minus 20. If it was 44 plus 20, that would still be minus 1.2 degrees? Instead of minus 3.2?
No, because it swing 40, because you have to go 20 to go back up to neutral and then 20 over, not swing 20.
So it would be 0.8.
Okay, 0.8 then.
Can you aim, move, and then shoot Desperado? Is that a thing?
No, we can move and shoot, or we can aim and shoot.
Well, he said the narrow example move is...
Actually, yes. Yes, you can, because
it's
you
a
can
free
aim.
Action.
You can aim, and then you can move, and then you can take a free action and shoot.
Because moving is only half action.
If you're between 2 and 3 meters, you're at point blank range, plus 30, which is, like, really good. It's really hard to miss point blank.
Makes sense.
Makes sense. So noted.
And also notably, it only says a move action, not what that move action is. I'm assuming you could run and still fire as a free action.
Huh.
Yeah, that's true.
Although that you wouldn't want to do that in this case.
Can you also... can you not charge and then shoot as a free action?
No, because charge has to be a melee thing. It charges itself an attack, not a move action.
I mean,
and
I
you want to take a turn then?
But yeah, the point is you do appear to have hit that dude.
Okay, then I will roll damage. It's 1d10 plus 4.
What's the armor penetration? Oh, right. One of your allies just attacked him. That means you get to reroll any ones or twos on damage.
Nice! That's much better. I like that.
Yeah, what's the armor penetration on your hotshot las pistol?
Sorry.
It'd be called pen next to type.
7.
So 7 pen. Yeah, that helmsman's armor isn't there, as far as your gun is concerned.
Wow, 7. What kind of gun is that?
Hot shot.
Okay, so it's still only a one shot.
No, it has a belt pack with a line connected to it.
Okay.
A hot shot rifle would have a backpack with a line connected to it.
Oh, yeah, okay, yeah, I remember that. Right?
Yeah, but when you're using the hot shot charge packs, that's one that's big enough to fit in the gun, which means it's not enough for more than one shot.
Stormtroopers use it in Imperial Guards.
Yeah, Stormtroopers usually have the backpacks.
What, Star Wars?
Stormtroopers are a type of, they're like the Inquisition's soldier men.
Yeah, Inquisitorial Stormtroopers. You know that hotshot pack you have for your long las?
Yeah.
They basically have a backpack, so they can do that with every shot, just with a big cable connected to their gun.
Oh man, I want one of those. What are the penalties for having something like that?
Just that it's really fucking heavy and bulky.
It's not a big deal. I don't know.
I don't know if it works with a long las. That might actually be something that Hodor just started with for his regular rifle, though. For his
Hellgun?
Hellgun, yeah. A Hellgun is a hotshot las gun.
Okay. He doesn't use it.
no, he doesn't. But yeah, Bob's pistol would also be called a Hell pistol. Alternatively. Because this is Warhammer. So of course it is. And okay, you shot that man right in the chest with... Okay, he's breathing in his own vaporized self. So that's unpleasant for him. He's stunned, and he's taking 1, 2, 3. Of the 12 degrees of fatigue, and is stunned, and unconscious, and has breathed in his own flesh.
Yep, that's generally how it goes.
So yeah, that man is unconscious and smoldering. So, Titus, one armsman's head exploded all over everybody nearby, and the other one has passed out from inhaling too much of himself. There is one terrified scribe pushing a cart full of Tau-modified weaponry and straight-up Tau-manufactured weaponry.
Titus walks around the corner. I think I can only move, like, 3, so I can only go this far. And he's pointing his last pistol at the scared scribe. And he's going to say that, too many people have already died in the name of the greater good. Lay down your arms, and you will be spared.
Oh. Oh, poor scribe. Do an intimidate.
My intimidate is garbage! So I'm gonna add plus 10 to this, because I think the thing I can still do, right?
Let's say another plus 20 to that as well.
Oh, okay. Alright, that makes my actual thing not that garbage.
No, let's say 30. His friend's brains are flaming on his body.
Okay, then, alright, this is like a 50-50 shot, so... Hey, I rolled like a 2 or something.
He rolled a 5. He rolled a 10, which was pretty good for an NPC trying to resist something, but it's not 5 degrees.
Hooray!
So yeah, there are certain benefits to absolutely murdering everybody horrifically in front of somebody who is not supposed to see anything. Who's the only thing he's supposed to see the inside of is a desk drawer, not his friend's cranial cavity.
Yep. Not his friend run away on fire headless.
Yeah. The other one's technically alive, but he has no way of knowing that. He doesn't look alive after what Bob and Krell did to him.
Armsman Chicken and Armsman Vape.
I get it.
So yeah, the scribe throws up his hands, drops his data slate. I don't have the arms, sir.
It's like, I don't have any arms. Looks down at thing full of arms.
Then, what's in the cart, dear friend?
But you're not holding any arms, sir.
Titus is gonna kind of like nod for someone to just knock him out already.
Now bonk him with like the butt of the whatever my stick
Where's
is.
Where's my character? Oh, he's way back here.
I assume that's where you put him.
Yeah, sorry, I wasn't zoomed out. All right, I'm gonna jump down on the grappling hook and walk up as well.
Oh, and for what it's worth, Bob also has a grappling hook.
So many grappling hooks. You're all Batman. I don't need a grappling hook. I have several things on my back.
You wouldn't be able to, like, you're too heavy. You're way too heavy to grapple anywhere.
Exactly. I would just eventually get enough arms that they do the grappling for me.
There's actually a specific set of arms that does exactly that in Dark Heresy, the Lathe Worlds books. Because in the Lathe Worlds, the gravity changes so often, tech priests just get arms installed to anchor them in place. Okay, so you're going to give him a whack with your maul?
Yeah. But like the bot, so non-lethal and all that.
Not shocking.
Well, the shocking part of it is the non-lethal part.
Oh, okay, then yeah, shock away. GG.
Although admittedly, it usually comes along with a good whack. Not murdering people is hard. But... Oh, it's a shock wall, not a power wall.
Yes, one-handed. I have a shield in the other hand.
Well, I was going to say it has a low power mode, but it's power walls that have a low power mode, not shock walls. The low power mode for a power wall is still... Well, I guess it's actually slightly less damage than a shock wall, but more pen still. It's still a power weapon. But yeah, so you curmudgeon him in the back of the head.
Wait, you curmudgeon him?
Like curmudgeon. Scrum
came over. Bob came over and just curmudgeoned him.
So, this guy is unconscious from getting a bonk on the back of the head. This guy is unconscious from having most of his chest turned into vapor that he then inhaled back inside of his chest.
Can Walpurga just walk over and then just suddenly, like, go to the flaming body and suddenly spray it with a bunch of the gel, the antibacterial gel, and just put out the fire that way?
What antibacterial gel do you know that isn't flammable?
Good point. I need like a water bottle type thing.
And so yeah, Kart O Tau weapons. Well, Tau and human or Tau modified human weapons.
Well, I guess it's time to stick a man in a deep, dark hole and torture him for absolutely no reason.
Yep. Let's do it.
Being Utopia-based now.
This couldn't have gone better.
It went rather well.
And so, I guess that...
You work fairly logically.
And so, I guess, with the exception of the, so basically the weapons, aside from the Tau-modified bolt pistol, that I had noted as loot that you guys had gotten for the Rogue Trader group are now technically loot that you guys have at the Dark Heresy group.
But are we not using those weapons to break them out?
Well, whatever you want to use them for.
Handy will use them?
I mean, you can use anything at a minus 20.
The local Arbites did, and they were then modified by the Tau.
Oh, right.
I'm surprised they didn't make them shittier somehow.
They don't really get melee weapons, but that doesn't mean that they can't put Tau technology into a power field generator.
Yeah, they have cool melee weapons.
I do know they have Tau that, suits. Like... Yeah, you know they have that like one sword that also outrights a fusion blaster, which is pretty sweet.
Although, admittedly, the Tau melee weapons on the battle suits are just shittier versions of what Imperial things of the same size are. Like, sure, they have an Onager gauntlet, which is basically just a giant power fist, which is worse than a dreadnought close combat weapon on a Space Marine dreadnought of comparable size. Because the Tau don't get it. Except for perhaps Commander Farsight's sword, which is probably not a Necron weapon.
So is that how the Space Marines defeat Tau? They just get in close combat and fuck them?
Or sometimes they outshoot them. It's usually like a number situation. Tactics, or what have you.
Yeah, also, Tau are actually pretty good at getting away from melee combat. They have a lot of things that can help with that.
The Tau are really good at... The Tau are really good at shooting, but the Space Marines are really good at not dying.
Really? They die like droves in every video I've seen of Space Marines fighting. Remember that one video I think you showed me? They fought Eldar and just got wrecked.
They did get wrecked. That happened.
Also, the Heretech, which is what the captain joined, could probably actually beat a whole bunch of Tau just because of the range shutdown power that she's got.
If she ever buys it, unless she did.
I hope she did. It's really good.
Where she showed up today. Although this has been fun.
She did. For a little bit.
Well, she messaged, not actually showed up for the game.
Yeah, true.
More, she had a delayed note of, hey, I'm not showing up for the game, about an hour after the game had already started. But so yeah, you guys have access to those Tau weapons now, and Tau modified human weapons.
Cool, so what's a Tau modified shock, whatever?
What?
Yeah, what is it? Can we use
Tau modified shower weapon? Yeah, it's just a normal. It's like a. It's just modified. It's not like a different.
Cool. Type I wanna, of weapon. Might want to use it instead of the long last. To be honest, I've. What is what are the stats on it?
It's not a long last. Just a regular las.
Yeah. No, I'm just asking. Because depending on how good it is, it might be worth replacing the long last with.
Let's see.
Is it just the +3/+3 thing for the, like most things?
Yeah, +3/+3 and gyro stabilized.
What about for the shock mauls, the meter weapons?
They're power mauls, not shock mauls.
Okay, yeah, I'll take one and I'll get rid of my last pistol.
Oh.
Actually, you know what?
I think I need Nazi's shock weapon.
Let's make those shock mauls. Well, one power maul, 4 shock mauls.
Okay.
Yeah, So could you just read out what the stats are on the Tau modified guns are? So I'm just gonna put it in right now.
The Tau modified. That is 200 meter range, 1d10 plus 6 damage, 3 pen, and shots are they ignore extreme range penalties. Those are only long range penalties.
All right, and rate of fire.
The same as a regular las gun, so single shot or 3-round burst.
Okay.
Clip 60, reload 1 full.
So half for me.
Yeah.
Alright, okay. It'll be a good thing to, if I don't kill them in one hit with the long las, then I'll open up with the long las and then switch to the switch to the las gun.
Oh, and actually, notably, your long las here in Dark Heresy 2 is only a full action to reload, so it's a half action with your,
Oh! Damn. Yeah. Okay.
So, in the future. Yeah, the long las would, is gonna deal more damage on an accurate hit or against things with unnatural toughness.
Yeah.
The Tau modified gun has no penetration, though.
And can fire 3 times in one turn.
Yes, although all las guns can do that.
Except for the long las.
Well, all regular las guns can do that. This is just a Tau, or this is just the las gun's been modified by the Tau.
Okay.
Does that mean we have pulse rifles and pulse pistols as well here?
All the Tau weapons were requisitioned.
Everything that's in chat. There's 4 rifles, 5 pistols.
Yeah.
Oh, I totally missed the chat thing.
He actually got the bolt pistol, right? That's different from the one that you linked in chat. Like, I physically have that. So that's not been stolen.
So, aside from the bolt pistol, because Thaddeus actively has that on his person.
Yeah.
How much is it to get a new weapon proficiency in Dark Heresy?
I believe that would be a matter of whatever the talent would cost with your aptitudes. Power Maul was Catherine's. The four Shock Mauls were her buddies.
Oh, okay. Then yeah, we have the plus three thing. So six damage, three pen instead of three.
Oh, melee weapons, it was a little different. Hold on.
No. That'd be different in a good way.
Maybe. We'll see.
So how are we going to break them out now?
YOLO.
YOLO is a great solution. You all die the first session. That's great.
No, we need to plan this as well as we plan the ambush.
Put a pistol in one of their cakes. And give it to them.
I don't know. I mean,
I could bribe some people away from their posts.
Okay, yeah. Actually, it does make melee weapons worse.
Worse?
A little bit better in some ways, but not in a significant way. It halves the weight, but reduces the damage by one.
What's the point? Don't want
to... because they're elegant in design and efficient by function, but clearly meant for ceremony more than function. Since the Tau do have plenty of melee weapons, just none of them are actually meant to see combat. Bonding knives, the Ethereal's double-sided blades. The Tau have melee weapons, but they're all, like, ceremonial.
It's like the people, the officers that carried fucking swords around in World War One and to a lesser extent in World War Two. Like, nobody used them.
Tau, the friggin' Ethereals, like, you know, the Tauiest of the Tau have got these big double-bladed sword staff things that...
That's counterblades.
They're friggin' Ethereals. Who expects the Ethereals to actually end up in combat?
Are the staffs, at least, are they good?
Not that good. I mean, better than the average monosword, but still shitty compared to anything an actual ass-kicker would be bringing to battle.
Okay. So, should I just pull them away from their post?
Yeah.
Or should we just assault the...
The less people know, the better.
Notably, you did not get the Tau fusion gun, because that's built into the stealth suit.
Okay, so once we break her out, we gotta get her on a transport or something back to Earth. Or back to Earth, but back to the Tau planet.
Bolo's world,
yeah.
Well, also preferably unconscious, so she doesn't know who took her. She's just like, what the fuck? I'm awake on the planet?
I thought we wanted her to know that,
What is us?
Best case scenario is she dies. Because then we sow the seeds of doubt among the ship to say that the Loyalists did it, but then we go down, we try to spread on the planet that they just killed the captain unceremoniously.
Yeah, do we have a spread disinformation equivalent? I think I can do that.
I would have to check the skill uses. I mean, obviously that's a thing you can do. It's just a question of exactly what skill it would be.
Deceive?
I mean, that's the skill for a disinformation campaign when you're doing ship actions, when you're lying to your own crew to make them think everything's okay.
Yeah, but we want to spread disinformation on the ground. I wonder how we'd do that.
I'm assuming it's still deceive. It's the same concept.
No, I was wondering how we would access the ground comms. Can we just get access to them from the ship?
Well, we just get into their Vox network and
bada bing, bada boom.
Okay, cool.
Yeah, I'll do it in person.
So what? I'll just pull the guards away. We'll go in. We'll fucking kill her. And then,
kill her with
one of the Tau guns.
Why?
Make it look like a Tau.
We want to kill her with one of the Imperium guns if you want to make the guards look older.
But if we want to blame it on the Loyalists.
The Loyalists broke her out. Why would they then shoot her?
Oh, okay.
So we're already changing our plan here.
The plan was always to break them out. I just thought that the way we break them out is give the prisoners guns and let them do what they want to.
Oh. So I'm keeping this particular Tau gun, but we can give the prisoners the rest of the guns.
We can give the prisoners a bunch of pistols and have them break out on their own. That way we don't have a finger. It doesn't come back to us very well. If we give them guns, you know, sneakily. And
yeah, but we should give
if they all die, if they all die, who cares? We don't need to get them out. We just need them to think that they could get out.
Or we give them, yeah, we let them like begin the breakout, and then we aid in the suppression.
I mean, if you want to be a hero and bring attention to yourself, you do that. Personally, right, I'm a spy agent, so I'm gonna keep a low profile.
We should give them at least some of the Tau weapons that we stole. To make it look like. Yeah.
That is true. I personally am not taking a Tau weapon. I'm probably never gonna buy another weapon proficiency anyway. So who cares?
Okay. So. What am I going to say to pull the guards away from their post? I might just radio the guards that are at their cell and be like, listen, guys. Hodor's on his way up, and he's not looking happy. You might want to just get out of his way. Or something like that.
That's assuming you have the authority to do that, which you don't.
That seems more like a friendly warning than an order.
Yeah.
Fair enough. I guess we're hoping they're not brave.
But in that case, it would be more of a deception role.
Yeah. So I'm going to radio them. Be like, look, hey guys, Hodor's on his way up. You might want to get out of the... You really want to get out of the way. He doesn't look really happy, and you know like what happens when things get in his way. I'm going to spend a fate point.
Oh, actually success. Armsmen are not trained in scrutiny in the first place, and even if they were, they botched that role. Oh, right. Well, Hodor, the big hulking mutant day.
Yeah, he's, I'm sitting here, I'm just watching some of the vid feeds. He's already, broken the two armsmen that got in his way on the way in. You really don't want to be there when he gets there.
He does not.
I think he wants to talk to the prisoner. He might even want to kill a prisoner.
Oh, wait, no, you had Sotal. You had Sotal Guardsmen got in.
And what?
Oh, it's just occurring to me that it wasn't the ship's normal armsmen guarding. It was the Sotal 39th Imperial Guardsmen that you recruited that were guarding the place right now.
Okay, yeah.
Yep. They were, like, different stances on the ship.
A little bit different stats, more to the point that they're American Southwestern as opposed to
oh, right, okay, just the accent.
British. Also.
Well, that was your British accent.
Well, not precisely. Well, a region.
Okay.
More the low Gothic gutter speak Imperial Guardsman thing. Oh, well, shit. So, we should get the fuck out of here.
Yeah, I bet. Shit, I wouldn't want to be anywhere near you guys right now.
What if we just, like, get in the corner or something?
I wouldn't even risk it. You've seen how he throws his weight around. You might get hit by accident.
Right, we get lunch? I'm gonna go to lunch. Let's go get lunch.
Alright. Good choice, guys. I was hoping to get to you guys before he did, so... Yeah, over and out.
Right, what was your name, boy?
Let's make up.
I'm Josh, up from, security office.
Nice.
You talk to me. It's pretty good.
It's a good name.
Yeah, it's a great name.
Right, well, I guess we'll be seeing you soon.
Yep, see you soon. Alright, radio the guys be like, you guys got a 10 to 15 minute window before they realize that Hodor's not coming down here.
Well, I'm assuming that, you know, I'm already in position, being a janitor and all, with a bunch of guns underneath my trash cans.
Alright. Go.
There are still a pair of guards at the front. The entire security team isn't abandoning me on that alone. The interior people at the cells, however. The actual patrols at the cell, the five guys there. They're out of there.
This is also a security thing, probably, for cameras.
Cameras is relevant.
Do you have, do you want to see if you can turn the cameras off and,
No, I got this. I'm going to go up to the guardsman and the one that's guarding Catelyn's cell. And I'm going to use the suggestion power.
The cells are currently unguarded. It's the guys guarding the detention block itself.
Oh, okay, that's fine too. I'm going to go up to one of them and I'm going to use a psychic power because that's the thing I can do.
All right, folks, power test.
All right, we're doing this.
Willpower plus, I assume you have a side focus.
I do, but it's minus 10 opposed willpower. So, we're doing this.
It brings up to normal.
Yeah, so plus 10 with the side focus, so that comes up to plus 0.
Yeah. You know what? I'll spend one of my fate points on this. Why not? I've got 4. All right.
Okay, you succeeded by 3.8 degrees. He failed by about 3.6.
Great. I'm just going to... He's going to go in and say that he needs to change out the... I don't know. I'm assuming they have indoor plumbing, but he's going to say that he needs to change out some stuff in the cells.
He needs to change out some stuff in the cells.
I'd very much so appreciate it if you would... allow me to avoid the dangers of these prisoners and do so in an expedient manner.
We'll let you avoid the dangers of the prisoners in an expedient manner.
Alright. So I'm hoping that lets me go through.
Go through. Go through.
All right. Basically what I'm hoping is that they have trash of some kind around somewhere, or even if he's just changing the sheets, something like that. And he basically just has, like, a pistol with a bit of ammo, like, rolled into the sheets. And then when he unrolls them, there's conveniently, you know, a gun on the bed. And then he takes his sheets and puts them in and then does that for however many prisoners he can afford to do that for. And then leaves.
All right, and were you wanting securities off for this? That was a Walperga thing.
Yeah, you said you didn't. You said you took care of this, but there are still cameras.
I'm hoping that, like, putting the thing, like, you wouldn't. It'd be like you pick up a blanket and then you unfold it. And, like, there wouldn't be a point in which you could hopefully, obviously, see the guns, but that doesn't mean that we wouldn't want to try to turn off the cameras, if that makes sense.
Yeah, I still do it, but there's still... You should roll sleight of hand, actually. Do you have it?
I think it's just called stealth, though. Is it? I don't know. I think sleight of hand is still a thing.
Do I have sleight of hand? If that's an advanced skill? No, I don't.
No, actually, it's not even a skill on here. Never mind.
Well, that's just because that skill list is a Dark Heresy 1 skill list, because... We're playing Rogue Trader, so our original sheets I put in were Dark Heresy 1 sheets. So sleight of hand is the skill.
Okay.
It's agility and knowledge, aptitudes, and intelligence-based.
Well, considering how it's not on the basic list, it means that it's probably advanced, which means I can't use it.
I have a feeling, like, if you're trying to sneak the blank, you should be able to roll something for it.
Concealment.
Yeah.
It's not on Dark Heresy's specialist skill list, at least. It's a basic skill there.
Oh, is it? Okay, then yeah, I'll try that. If I can use intelligence... Oh, then fuck it. Then I don't care. It'll be fine.
Yeah, those cameras are off. And elegantly, too. Not that brute force security measures.
Like a damn professional.
I kind of want to see the shit show that this is going to cause for the rest of the crew. I kind of like this.
Oh, you're definitely going to see this. It, because we're going to have to deal with it.
I mean, I don't like that this is happening, but I also like that this is happening.
I was still kind of hoping for something to go wrong at the worst moment, but we don't get caught, so it's kind of like we're Team Rocket.
I mean, we're at very least... I can tell you Romeo's at very least going to fire those guardsmen, and then also maybe try to track, like, yeah.
I think we're going to end up tracking ourselves, yeah. We're going to have to do an investigation on our own selves.
Oh, it's gonna remind me of that session where I fucking set half the ship on fire.
Ah, yeah.
And I knew the that entire happened. Time what happened, and then you guys were like, what if this happened? What if this happened? I had to sit there. I was like, fuck! It was good.
So, yeah. I assume they get their guns. And,
yes. However many of those guns and photon grenades you want to distribute to them, you can.
I'd assume anything that isn't taken is given to them. So whatever anyone called is theirs, I don't want any of these, because I'm probably never ever going to spend money or spend EXP on these, so why do I care?
I'm sad that I don't have any tau guns now.
I still got the stealth suit.
Yeah, it's gonna be a while till we'll be able to use it, I think.
I mean, we'll probably get these tau guns back.
I don't think they're going to make it off the ship, personally.
That's true.
Eric, that's, I think you got to do some. I think you got to do some rolls to see how far they make it. Should we actually, like, notify somebody right away? Like, should we, like, call it in? Just to make sure they don't get off the ship? We want them to die, right?
It doesn't matter to me. And right now, Titus is basically trying to keep its hands off as he can with everything. So if you want to do that, go ahead. But, yeah.
All right, we can do hands off.
Just because, like, you know, if our cover gets blown, we're fucked. And anything we do is another threat that can be back to us. And that's basically where I'm coming at it from. Not saying we shouldn't, just saying that. That's how my dude sees it. Yeah, they have a lot of guns. And balls, if they want them, I guess.
Hey, balls help. Especially because they're blindy balls that only the actual party members have, any resistance to?
Oh, I meant the, So,
Eric, you gonna do some rolls to see how far they go? Because I'm kind of interested.
I can definitely pop up some rolls to see what they end up doing and how far they end up going. Are you guys planning to do any kind of... So you have armed them and set them on their way.
That's going to be bad for our... probably both morale and crew population.
I don't think they're a big enough force to really make a dent in either one, but also morales don't really matter that much with Romeo around.
And also, how quickly are the actual, like, the other characters alerted of this stuff going down? Because this was a pretty big deal for us, so... Or at least having them on ship was a big deal for them, so they'd be probably kept under... Not, I guess, not watch in this case, but, like, knowledge in the know.
They would have been kept under pretty heavy watch and knowledge from those guards who are no longer there, and all of the security observing systems that have been shut off.
That's true.
Well, I'm pretty sure the two guys on the outside, like, unless they got, like, immediately both killed right at the start, would probably alert somebody.
Yeah.
Also,
the
moment they get out of the cell block, they're going to deal, like, with cameras because you can't shut all of them off.
Yeah, stage one would be, what do they do with the guys who are immediately outside?
Oh, yeah, and I just wanted to add in that when Titus is planting all the weapons, he's going to make some obvious allusions to, like, you know, special bed sheets from friends on the outside or something like that. But, you know, enough of us string together to make it seem like, you guys have friends on the ship, congratulations.
Alright, yeah, I definitely know what you're talking about, that typical prison break thing.
Yep.
That's also hilarious, because they're dirty, dirty heretics.
Yes, you're the furthest they have from friends.
Yes. Well, we want them to think that they have friends, and we want everybody else in the ship to think that they had friends, so that they get paranoid. So,
yes. It's a situation of complete opposites. You guys are the furthest thing they have from friends, and you want them to think that you're their friends, whereas your rogue trader characters are the closest thing they have to friends, and that they think are the furthest thing they have from friends.
Yep.
Okay, are any of you guys sticking by or keeping watch or anything of the sort as this is going on, like as they make their way out?
I'm sure she would just turn the cameras back on and watch from there, or no?
I didn't Titus know has any... a man.
Yeah?
Titus is a man he used to go torture, so he's not sticking around.
Do you have the interrogation skill?
I do actually have the interrogation skill.
I would definitely call that an interrogation test.
Cool. You know what? Whatever, man. You're in a session. Another plus 10. Let's do it.
No, it would also be good if we could find that.
I feel like
we haven't done that yet.
I feel like that might be a little bit out of our depth. But
really?
We could try.
I think it would be very useful.
Find the what?
The water.